Jarvis.
Welcome, Holmes.
I am Iron Man. You think you're the only superhero in the world? Mr. Stark, you've become part of a bigger universe. You just don't know it yet.
Who the hell are you?
Nick Fury, director of S.H.I.E.L.D.
Oh.
I'm here to talk to you about the Avenger Initiative.
And just like that, ladies and gentlemen, the face of comic book movies was changed forever as we took our first steps into a larger universe. The Marvel Cinematic Universe, to be exact, or as I call it, Cinematic Blackmail. Seriously, if you skip just one movie in this franchise, your chances of understanding future plots and the rest of the series drops dramatically, thus forcing you to see the adaptations of comic books you either don't read or haven't even heard of. That being said, I actually have enjoyed some of the movies in this franchise, with some exceptions. So will Captain America: The Winter Soldier be another exception? Let's take a look and find out. So welcome to Short and to the Point, where I review movies in 5 minutes or less, or your money back. And just a friendly heads up to those of you that do not know the identity of the Winter Soldier, I am unabashedly going to spoil that plot point, so stop watching this video now if you do not want to know. Too late! His identity is... What does she want? Megan, what are you doing here?
You know why I'm here.
No, I don't.
You told the audience I left the show. I didn't leave the show. I just said I needed a little time off. Why didn't you tell the audience that?
Okay, first off, what audience? And secondly, you live in North Carolina. I can't just tell my non-existent audience, oh, you'll be back someday, and then it never happens. I hate it when shows do that.
Well, little brother, consider me an occasional guest star. That way, you don't have to come up with any excuses for why I'm not present in every episode. Besides, the excuses were starting to get lame and stupid anyway.
Just start the opening titles.
Gladly.
Strong and brave, here to save the American way.
Welcome to Captain America: Modern Warfare, everyone. World War II's over, but there's still plenty of evil out there for Captain America to dish out some old-fashioned justice to. Just minutes into the film, our heroes leap into action and kick some 21st century butt while looking awesome doing it. In all seriousness, this modern setting was one of my favorite parts of the film. It's been 70 years, give or take, since Captain Steve Rogers froze himself to save the day, but the only things that seem to have changed is that we've come up with more impressive ways to kill one another. For example, remember the helicarrier from the Avengers? Well, now there's three of them that are going to be launched up into the sky and play Big Brother with the world beneath them to preemptively neutralize threats before they even happen. Cap is obviously not on board with this, saying that this is not freedom, but fear. Director Nick Fury reminds our hero that he's done some questionable things in the past, and this is all just a consequence of progress. He tells Cap that S.H.I.E.L.D. takes the world as it is, not as they'd like it to be. And that's kind of a heavy thing to tell Captain America, given how he almost died trying to protect the freedom of his country in the last film. Speaking of that, there are some bittersweet callbacks to the first Avenger, such as what became of Peggy Carter after Cap froze himself, and as it turns out, Cap freezing himself caused more problems than it solved, which I liked, because that plot point from the last film was a rather rushed and cheap way to get Captain America into the Avengers as soon as possible. Now let's get down to the plot of the film. To make a long story short, but without delving too far into spoilers, the enemies are within S.H.I.E.L.D. this time, forcing Captain America and the Black Widow to go on the run in order to find out who was behind this conspiracy and figure out what their big plan is. The minute that Nick Fury is ambushed, you know things just got real. Yes, when compared to Captain America the First Avenger, Captain America the Winter Soldier has a noticeable but welcome shift in tone. Don't expect any of the hammy acting from Hugo Weaving to be present in our villains in this film. They are straight up serious and are all the more effective for it. They even have their own answer to Captain America in the form of the Winter Soldier, who we all know is Bucky, who somehow survived falling to his death in the First Avenger. Yeah, that plot point is kind of clumsily explained, but they do give a decent explanation for how he's still young. It takes about half the story to reveal that Bucky is the Winter Soldier, but when it is finally revealed, the writers actually managed to pull a fast one on us and made this non-twist worth it. Bucky also feels more like an antithesis to Captain America than the Red Skull did, as they are both trump cards for their respective sides, but are used in different ways. When these two fight, pardon my language, but it is a badass case of what happens when an otherwise unstoppable force makes a head-on collision with an immovable object. The action in general is well choreographed and heart-pumping without going overboard, though the film does fall victim to the typical cliche of superhero battles wiping out a good few city blocks. There is a no-one-is-safe vibe to this film, as our heroes don't have S.H.I.E.L.D.'s resources at their disposal and are up against a small army that even manages to have Captain America on the ropes even when the Winter Soldier is not present. Getting back to the Winter Soldier, I did actually have a few issues with how long it took for them to reveal that Bucky is the Winter Soldier. Like I said, it takes half the runtime at least to reveal that Bucky is the Winter Soldier, and the way he is used during that time doesn't give Sebastian Stan a lot of time to act. Though I will say that when Sebastian Stan does get a chance to act, he does show that he's a good actor, even when it's just through facial expressions. As for the rest of the acting in this movie, it was nothing special. It's not bad, but the performances give as much as the roles demand, and they don't go much further than that. Not much has changed about Chris Evans' performance as Captain America or Scarlett Johansson's performance as the Black Widow, but I do think that they fit their characters, and they do manage to work well off of one another. There is also newcomer Sam Wilson, who was played by Anthony Mackie. He didn't exactly blow me away, but his character did make a good first impression. So overall, I enjoyed Captain America: The Winter Soldier. It's a fun and easy movie to pick up, but it is not simple-minded either. Now, the plot of the film can be a little hard to follow due to the confusing accusations that are thrown around, but the pacing is good enough that it keeps you invested until the answers finally arrive. Also, the film fixed some issues I had with previous Marvel movies, such as Iron Man 3's pacing issues and Thor 2's underwhelming villains. I give it 8.5 post-credit sequences out of a possible 10, and I do recommend it for a theatrical viewing. This has been Shorted to the Point, and I review movies in 5 minutes or less, or your money back. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to go rewrite a few scripts to reincorporate my sister into them. So I will see you all soon. Bye.